A domain name is a mapped against the IP address. So each domain name would have a unique IP address. So this whole thing is called URL, Universal Resource Locator. Almost any domain that you could think of would have been purchased or taken away. Today, you know, you can't decide a company name and then look for a good domain name. You have to first look for a domain name, or jo mila, then you decide a company name. Your customer is the right person to give you the right opinion. Okay, so ask your customers and check a good domain for yourself.
So everything was confusing around pay, the word pay.
Just make it simple and relevant to your business. As simple as that.
Live within the variety of TLDs that a lot of people are using. Don't go to a completely new TLD. So if you don't get a .com, go to a .in, go to a .co.in, go to a .biz or a .net.
Now, when I log into Yahoo, based on my computer IP, they give me in.yahoo.com.
What if I have a parent domain name and then have links for these, for example, SMEs and corporate?
What about those cases where the TLD is different but the brand is the same?
So that's another way of doing it. So either you do .uk, .in,
.co.uk,
.aus, and so people do that.
Sir, I have heard that there is a recent trend across the West that they are using complete lines as domain names.
A domain name is an online address. When you want a customer to come to your web store, online store, you have to give them a domain name. URL is not domain name, okay, don't get confused. In fact, domain name is a part of URL. You'll be surprised to know that today, there are more than 900 extensions available from which you can select your TLD or extension. Whether a domain name is going to be brandable or searchable. And both has its own merits and demerits. Let me explain what it means.